بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، الصراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين، آمين. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد الفاتح لما أغلق، الخاتم لما سبق، ناصر الحق بالحق، والهادي إلى صراطك المستقيم، وعلى آله حق قدره ومقداره العظيم. ورضي الله تعالى عن أصحاب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم، ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. يا أئمة الشيخ، دور لنا بها المحضر لتعطفي بنظرة تاتي لنا بظفري. وبعد، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. Dear brother and sister, Imam Sheikh Zaim Jama'at Sunnah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. I am very happy to be here with my brothers and sisters in Islam to give short piece, speak about Islam and Maqam al-Ihsan, that is at-tasawuf. At-tasawuf, that means Sufism. It comes from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because only the names that come after Prophet, but all the practicing in tasawuf, we get all that from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because if tasawuf is conclusion, making khalwa, making zikr, that everybody know that it's come from Prophet. Because he used to spend 40 days in Ghar al-Hira to worship Allah. If it's tasawuf, is to be quiet, also that is come from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because he said, من كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فليقل خيرا أو ليصمت. Whoever believe Allah on the last day, say good or be quiet. And he used to stay some days without eating anything. Also, that is the way of the tasawuf, to clean their nafs. They stay hungry just to clean their nafs. Also, that's come from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Al-Islam, everybody know, is the deen with Allah. Inna deen inda Allah al-Islam. But Islam has different levels. Al-Islam, wal-Iman, wal-Ihsan. And those levels, you found it in Hadith. Hadith of Jibreel, that famous Hadith everybody knows. When Jibreel came to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and asked him, "Akhbirni anil Islam." Tell me about Islam. He said, Prophet answer, "Islam an tashhada an la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammadan rasulullah wa iqam as-salat wa ita'i zakat wa sawm ramadan wa hajj al-bayt min istata'a ilayhi sabila." He gave him 5 pillars of Islam. And Jibreel say, "Sadaqta." What he say is true. And the Sahaba, they wonder. He's asking Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and give confirmation that what the answer Prophet give is true. From that hadith, you can know that it's possible for human being, regular human being, to see the angels, because all the Sahaba was around Prophet, they were seeing Jibreel, and they were told is one of them. And he asked him another question, "Akhbirni anil imani," tell me about iman, the belief. Say, "Antumina billahi wa malaikati wa kutubi wa rusuli wa liyum al-akhir." Iman, have to believe Allah and his books and his angel and his messenger and all everything you believe that is come from Allah, the good and bad, everything is from Allah. Al-Qada wal-Qadar. He says Sadaqta. And he asked him, Alim Ihsan. He said, tell me about Ihsan. He said, Prophet said, Al-Ihsan, أن تعبد الله كأنك ترى. إن لم تكن تراه إنه يرى. Ihsan is to worship Allah like you seeing him. If you don't get to that, you worship Allah like Allah seeing you. Between two things, if you worship Allah like that way, all your ibadah going to be in the best way. If you're dealing with the people with Ihsan, also you deal with them in the best way. If you talk with Ihsan, you talk with the best way. That's why we can tell that Deen is three level: Al-Islam, Al-Iman, Al-Ihsan. Al-Islam is قول لا إله إلا الله. Islam is to say لا إله إلا الله. Al-Iman, to know there is no God but Allah. Like the ayah the brother just read, فَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَالسَّابِ لِذَنْبِكَ. Allah said to Prophet, no, there is no God but Allah. You know, that level is different from just saying it. You can't say لا إله إلا الله in your tongue, but you don't have it in your heart. But if you have it in your heart, that you know it, that is Iman. فَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ. That's why Prophet said about Abu Bakr Siddiq, he said, مَا فَضُلَكُمْ أَبُو بَكْرٍ بِكَسْرَةِ صَلَاتِهِ وَلَا بِكَسْرَةِ صِيَامِهِ وَلَكِنْ بِشَيْءٍ وَقَرَ فِي قَلْبِهِ. Abu Bakr is not best of you because he make a lot of salat or a lot of siyam, but because of something that in his heart, that is his Iman. So Al-Islam, قَوْلٌ بِاللِّسَانِ. You say it with your tongue. وَاعْتِقَادٌ بِالْجَنَانِ. And believe it in your heart. وَعَمَلٌ بِالْأَبْدَانِ. And you work for it. That's why if Al-Iman is عِلْم بِاللَّا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ, but Ihsan is جَرَيَانَ عَلَى مُقْتَدَى لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. Ihsan is to do all your deeds based on لا إله إلا الله. That is Maqam al-Ihsan. Each one of these three levels have three different levels. Al-Islam divided to Al-Tawbatu, Al-Istiqamatu, Al-Taqwa. Al-Tawbatu means to do repentance to Allah. That is the way of the Sufi. Real repentance is to go into all good deed and leave all bad deed. But Tawbah also has different levels. Tawbatul Amma, Tawbatul Khasa, Tawbatul Khasatul Khasa. The regular people, if they do repentance, they're doing repentance for doing the haram things and leave the obligation. So if they make Tawbah, they make Tawbah for that. But Allah still loves them. Inna Allaha yuhibbu at-tawwabina wa yuhibbu al-mutatahhirina. Allah loves those they do repentant and those they clean themselves from the bad deeds. The second level of tawbah, ya tawbatul khassa. Those people, they make tawbah, they do repentant for doing the things that is not the best. They don't do any haram, but what they do is not the best, so they do repentant for that. That is tawbatul khassa. Tawbatul khassatul khassa, the highest level of tawbah, those people, they do repentant for see their good deed. They don't see nothing but Allah, because they know the good deed is come from Allah, is not from them. And that's Quran said it. وَمَا بِكُم مِّن نِعْمَةٍ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ. Everything good with you is from Allah. So if you get to the point that you don't see the things, good things coming from anywhere but from Allah, and you make tawbah to see anything else that not from Allah, that is tawbah to al-khassatul khassa. That is biggest maqama of tawbah, because those people, they don't see their effort. There is The second level of Islam is istiqama. Istiqama means to be in the right path, right way. That is most important things that you can have, because Quran teach you that every day you praying, in your prayer, when you get to إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين, Allah said, هذا بيني وبين عبدي ولعبدي ما سأل. This is between me and my servant. Whatever my servant asks me, I give it to him. But Allah don't let you to ask whatever. He teach you what you have to ask, because it the best is istiqama, to be in the right path. That's why you ask Allah, اهدنا صراط المستقيم. Guide us to the right way. Also, if you look to the word, you didn't say guide me. You say guide us, just to make sure that you pray with congregation, to make sure that whenever you pray for yourself, you pray for your brothers. But istiqama have also three different levels. The first level of istiqama, you found it in the ayah. قل تعالوا أتل ما حرم ربكم عليكم لا تشركوا به شيئا وبالوالدين إحسانا ولا تقتلوا أولادكم من إملاق نحن نرزقكم إياهم ولا تقربوا الفواحش ما ظهر منها وما بطن ولا تقتلوا النفس التي حرم الله إلا بالحق ذلكم وصاكم به لعلكم تعقلون ولا تقربوا مال اليتيم إلا بالتي هي أحسن حتى يبلغ أشده وأوفوا الكيل والميزان بالقسط وإذا قلتم فاعدلوا ولو كان ذا قربى وبعهد الله أوفوا ذلكم وصاكم به لعلكم تذكرون وأن هذا صراطي مستقيما فاتبعوه ولا تبعوا السبل فتفرق بكم عن سبيل. استقامة, in this ayah Allah teach us what is the istiqama. You have it in those 10 things. لا تعبدوا إلا إياه, لا تشركوا بالله شيئا. You don't join anything else with Allah, that is shirk. You don't make shirk. You don't join anything with Allah. وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا, and you be nice with your parents. وَلَا تَقْتُلُوا أَوْلَادَكُمْ مِنْ إِمْلَاقٍ نَحْنُ نَرْزُقُكُمْ وَإِيَّاهُمْ. Don't kill your children because you fear of poverty. Because Allah say, we provide sustenance for you and for your children. Your wealth, Allah guaranteed that for you, and He guaranteed that for your children, that so you don't have to kill your children because you fear to be a poor man. وَلَا تَقْرَبُوا الْفَوَاحِشَ مَا ظَهَرَ مِنْهَا وَمَا بَطَنَ. Don't be near the bad things, either it's open or in secret. Don't do any bad things. Either you are alone or you are with the people. مَا ظَهَرَ مِنْهَا وَمَا بَطَنَ. وَلَا تَقْتُلُوا النَّفْسَ الَّتِي حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ إِلَّا بِالْحَقِّ. Don't kill a life that Allah make it haram to kill any innocent, any life just accept by justice. ولا تقتلوا أولادكم من إملاق نحن نرزقكم ولا تقتلوا النفس التي حرم الله إلا بالحق ذلك وصاكم به لعلكم تعقلون. This what Allah command to you, you may learn wisdom. So you learn wisdom from that. And he say, ولا تقربوا مال اليتيم إلا بالتي هي أحسن. Don't be near the orphans money or anything belong to him, except in the best way. Best way, that means you work for it and he gets more, but you don't use it. لا تقربوا مال اليتيم إلا بالتي هي أحسن حتى يبلغ أشده, until he get full age. وأوفوا الكيل والميزان بالقسط. If you're selling something, you weigh, you have to fool it in justice. وإذا قلتم فعدلوا. If you talk, speak in justice. ولو كان ذا قربى, even if it's near relative is concerned. وبعهد الله أوفوا, and fulfill the agreement between you and your Lord. All these nine things is regular istiqama. And the ayah said, وأن هذا صراطي مستقيما فاتبعوه ولا تبعوا السبل فتفرق بكم عن سبيل. That is my right way and follow it, don't follow different way and he take you away from Allah's way. The second level of istiqama is to love Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam better than everybody else, better than everything else, and love, mention his name and make salat ala nabi a lot. That you can understand it from the ayah when Allah said, "Inna alladhina qalu rabbuna Allahu zumma istaqamu." Those said that Allah is our Lord and they be in the right path. One sahaba came to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, asked him, he said, "The Islam is too much. I can't know everything. But I want you to give me one advice, that short advice that I can use it to save." And Prophet told him, "Qul amantu billahi thumma istaqim." Say, "I believe Allah," and you be in the right way. The highest level of istiqama is al-baqa ba'd al-fana. You know Allah, and you finish in Allah, and you know in reality there is nothing but Allah, la ilaha illa Allah, and you know la mawjuda bihaqqin siwa Allah, nothing exists in reality but Allah, because reality never change, and what you seeing every day is changing. That's why only Allah is real. That's why among the name of Allah, al-haqqu, because haqqu is something that never change. That's Allah. If you get to that maqam of istiqama, you have the real highest maqam of istiqama. Then we come to the maqam of taqwa. Taqwa is mean to fear Allah. Taqullaha la'allakum turhamun. Taqullaha alladhi tasa'alu nabi wal ahama. Inna Allaha kana alaykum raqiba. Taqwa, to fear Allah, is mean to follow the orders. When Allah say do, you do it. If Allah say stop, you stop. That's why Shaykh Ahmed al-Tijani radiallahu anhu, Shaykh al-Tariq al-Tijani, he said, "At-tasawuf, the Sufism, is imtisal al-amri wa ittinab al-nahi fi al-zahir wa al-batini min haythu yarda la min haythu tarda." At-tasawuf is to follow the order of Allah. When Allah asks you to do, you do. When Allah asks you to, when Allah forbid, you stop doing it. In zahir and in batin, open and in secret. The way that Allah wants is not the way you want. You can't worship Allah the way you want. You worship Allah the way Allah wants you to worship Him. That's what the ayah say, taqullaha mastata'tum. The first level of taqwa, Allah say, fear Allah as much as you can. But there is another ayah to show you there is, the level is higher than that. Because in another ayah he said, taqullaha haqqa tuqatihi. Fear Allah, the real taqwa, haqqa tuqatihi, wa la tamutunna illa wa antum muslimun. The biggest maqam of taqwa is what the arif Billah ibn Farid said, وَلَوْ خَطَرَتْ لِي فِي سِوَاكَ إِرَادَةٌ عَلَىٰ خَاطِرِي سَهْوًا قَضِيتُ بِرِدَّتِي. You get to the point that you don't think about anything, that's not Allah. That arif, he say, oh Allah, if I think about anything that is not you, I'm not considering myself among the believers. But that is the maqam of the arif. أو حال العارف, but the maqam of قطب. Any arif billah, he can get to that maqam, but only qutbu is the one who can stay in that maqam all the time. The qutbu is the highest level of the wilayah. Then we come to the second level of a deen, is al iman. Iman also have three different levels: as-sidqu, al-ikhlasu, at-tuma'ninatu. As-sidqu means to be truthful. But what the meaning to worship Allah because you want to get the good things with Allah, you worship Allah for that. In Quran, ليس البر أن تولوا وجوهكم قبل المشرق والمغرب ولكن البر من آمن بالله واليوم الآخر كتاب النبيين وآت المال على حبه ذوي القربى واليتامى والمساكين والموفون بعهدهم إذا عاهدوا والصابرين في البأساء والضراء حين البأس أولئك الذين صدقوا. To do all these good things, they are the people who are truthful. And Allah says in another ayah, يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وكونوا مع الصادقين. Fear Allah and be with the people who are truthful. The second level of as-sidq, that you love Allah more than everything, you love His name more than any other name, you love His zikr more than any zikr. If you get to that level of sidq, Allah will never put in your heart something you want to get and let Allah will let you have it. But the highest level of sidq is you get to the point that you believe all the knowledge that Allah gave to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, all the tajalli that Allah made to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, all the rules and all the adab that Allah gave to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then you come to sit al-ikhlas, al-ikhlas wama umiru illa liya'budu Allah mukhlisina lahu din. Sincerity, you worship Allah with ikhlas because Allah don't accept any deed without ikhlas. وَمَا أُمِرُوا إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ. So the first maqam of ikhlas, you do the good things for Allah. The second level, you do it, you don't wait to get anything, you don't fear to get punishment, but you do it because you know you are the servant of Allah and Allah is your Lord, you have to follow Him regardless what you're going to get from that. The highest level of ikhlas, إخراج السوى من معاملتك مع الله تبارك وتعالى. You don't have anything between you and Allah. You don't see anything that affected your work because you know the عمل من الله إلى الله. Everything is come from Allah to Allah. And everybody saying it because it's not only when somebody die, you have to understand that inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi rajiun. But you have to understand that all the time, you know that you belong to Allah and you're going back to Allah. So if yourself you come from Allah and going back to Allah, your deed also is from Allah to Allah. So if you get to that, you get to maqam al-ikhlas. And there is maqam at-tuma'nina. At-tuma'nina is comfort. That what Quran says, if you want to have it, you mention Allah. أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبِ. If you want to have comfort heart, you mention Allah. But tuma'nina, the regular people, they don't have tuma'nina. Because tuma'nina start only with the khasa. Those, they accept everything that Allah choose for them. They say, اللهم عليك معولي. You depend on Allah and what Allah decided for you, you accept it. The highest maqam of tuma'ninatu, you don't see anything else. If you don't see it, you don't have to depend on it. Then you come to darajat maqam al-ihsan. That is the highest maqam. أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه إن لم تكن تراه إنه يراك. Al-ihsan has three different levels. مراقبة المشاهدة المعرفة. مراقبة mean you observe Allah and you know all your deed is front of Allah. If you get to that, you do good things. There is مراقبة after مشاهدة. مشاهدة mean to face Allah and you know Allah has no place but that the word they can use. Then from muraqabah you get to the highest, that is ma'rifatullah, and know Allah. And you have to know that Allah, He created you just for that to know him. Because when Allah says in the Quran, وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدوني ما أريد منهم من رزق وما أريد أن يطعموني. He said, I didn't create human being and jinn for nothing, just to worship me. Ibn Abbas, he translated, he gave the meaning of that ayah. He said, يعني بيعبدوني يعرفوني. What Allah means? To worship him, to know him. Because if you don't know him, you don't know how to worship him. Those is the highest level of a deen, هو الإحسان. And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in hadith, إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَتَبَ الْإِحْسَانَ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ. Allah make ihsan obligation for anything that you're doing. It's not only for your salat, but for anything that you're doing. That's why if you go to Quran, you will see Allah mention that he loves people who have maqam ihsan. وَأَنْفِقُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ وَلَا تُلْقُوا بِأَيْدِيكُمْ إِلَى التَّهْلُكَةِ وَأَحْسِنُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Allah said, spend for the sake of Allah and don't put your hand in danger, like me, don't put yourself in something that can hurt you. وَأَحْسِنُوا and do good. Allah, he loves those who do good. In another ayah, I say, أَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةِ وَآتُوا الزَّكَاةَ وَمَا تُقَدِّمُوا لِأَنفُسِكُمْ مِنْ خَيْرٍ تَجِدُوا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ بَصِيرٌ. وَقَالُوا لَنْ يَدْخُلَ الْجَنَّةَ إِلَّا مَنْ كَانَ هُودًا أَوْ نَصَارَى تِلْكَ أَمَانِيُّهُمْ قُلْ هَاتُوا بُرْهَانَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. When the Jew and the Christian said, nobody going to go to paradise except the Jew and the Christian, Allah said, that is your wish, but bring your burhan if you are truthful. بَلَا مَنْ أَسْلَمَ وَجْهَهُ لِلَّهِ وَهُوَ مُحْسِنٌ فَلَهُ أَجْرُهُ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِ فَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. He said, who submit his all self to Allah and do good, he get his reward with his Lord, and he not fear today or tomorrow. In another ayah, وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ دِينًا مِمَّنْ أَسْلَمَ وَجْهَهُ لِلَّهِ وَهُوَ مُحْسِنٌ. Whoever can be better religion than who submit his whole self to Allah and do good and follow the way of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Ibrahim, he get to maqam al-ihsan. That's why he was humble in front of everybody. Allah saying another ayah, الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْظَ وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Also those they spend in easy time and hard time, and they forgive people. And he said, وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ, and Allah loves those who have ihsan, who do good. In hadith, in another ayah also, to show you that you need ihsan in all your activities. This is, he mentioned the people who spend the money. He said, Allah يُحِبُّ, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. To show you that you can have maqam ihsan in spending. He said here, وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا مِمَّنْ دَعَى إِلَى اللَّهِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا. Who can be better talk than who called to Allah and do the good things and said, I am among the Muslims. إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ مُحْسِنُونَ. Also Allah with those who fear Allah and those who do good. إِنَّ رَحْمَةَ اللَّهِ قَرِيبٌ مِنَ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. The mercy of Allah is close to people who get to maqam ihsan, who do good. لِلَّذِينَ أَحْسَنُوا الْحُسْنَى وَالزِّيَادَةِ. Those who do good, they have the reward. The reward is husna. Husna is mean here is paradise and with the other and more, the more to see Allah. So no way you can see Allah in the last day unless if you get to maqam ihsan. لِلَّذِينَ أَحْسَنُ الْحُسْنَى وَالزِّيَادَةِ. If you talk, you have to talk with ihsan. Allah said, وَقُولُوا لِلنَّاسِ حُسْنًا. Say to people good things. That's Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in many, many hadiths, إِنَّ الرَّجُلَ لَيُدْرِكُ بِحُسْنِ الْخُلُقِ دَرَجَةَ الْقَائِمِ الصَّائِمِ. He said, the man can get with good manners, and you cannot have good manners without ihsan. You get with good manners the level of people who praying all the night and fasting all the days. He said in hadith, أَنَا زَعِيمٌ بِبَيْتٍ فِي رَبْضِ الْجَنَّةِ لِمَنْ تَرَكَ الْمِرَاءَ وَإِنْ كَانَ مُحِقًا وَبِبَيْتٍ فِي وَسَطِ الْجَنَّةِ لِمَنْ تَرَكَ الْكَذِبَ وَإِنْ كَانَ مَازِحًا وَبِبَيْتٍ فِي أَعْلَى الْجَنَّةِ لِمَنْ حَسُنَ خُلُقُهُ. He said, I said, there is a place in the corner of Jannah for the people who live arguing with the people, even if you are, if you have truth. You don't argue with people, you leave it. Even you have truth, Prophet say you have place in Jannah. Also, in the middle of Jannah, he said, there's the place for the people who stop lying, who don't say lie, even if they play. So as a Muslim, you don't have to play with lie. Like the other people, they have like Ibril, they lie in Ibril and they say, they believe that is lawful. But as Muslim, we don't have that. That's why he said, the place in the middle of Jannah for the people who don't lie even if they are playing. وَفِي بَيْتٍ فِي أَعْلَى الْجَنَّةِ لِمَنْ حَسُنَ خُلُقُهُ. And he said, in highest maqam of Jannah, you will have the room for the people who have good manners. That's, they are the people who have ihsan. He said, حُسْنُ الْخُلْقِ مِنْ حُسْنِ الْعِبَادَةِ. To have good manners is the best way of ibadah. And أَقْرَبُكُمْ إِلَيَّ مَجْلِسًا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَحَاسِنُكُمْ أَخْلَاقًا. The closest people to my seat, يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, they are the people who have good manners. أَحَاسِنُكُمْ أَخْلَاقًا. And you know the word أَحَاسِن come from حَسَن and أَحْسَن. So all this good maqam in the last day, who gonna have it? They are the people who have maqam al-ihsan. So that's why all the Sufi people, they work hard to get to that maqam. They use many ways to get to that maqam, to mention Allah a lot, to be alone, all that just to get to maqam al-ihsan. Because tasawuf is nothing but following the footstep of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and mention Allah day and night. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa sallam.
JazakAllah khair. Interesting lecture. At this point in time, we will be entertaining questions from the audience. If anyone has any comments or questions with respect to the topic being discussed, Sheikh will be interested in giving a response to it. So if there are anyone who wants to have a comment or if there are questions with respect to the topic.
With regards to tasawuf, some Sufis say that when it is you meditate and you go deep into the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a lot of mystical things can happen, like for example, flying or levitating or going to the planets spiritually. Could you elaborate on this phenomenon, please?
Alhamdulillah, tasawuf is not for to get to that. It's not for to fly or to get all these things. Tasawuf is Tawheedullah, Ifrad al-Wijhati ila Allah. You submit yourself to Allah. All the way of Tasawuf is just to submit yourself to Allah. But if you submit yourself to Allah, Allah give you whatever He wants to give you. Because إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ مُحْسِنُونَ. If Allah be with you, Allah be with you with His power. And power of Allah can do everything. But you don't go into Tasawuf because you want to get karam. But every Muslim, truthful Muslim, can get karam. You see that in the Hadith, you see it in Quran. Many people that Allah mentioned that they have biggest karam. In Hadith, Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam mentioned three people who get to a cave and the big rock come and they don't have way to go out. What they do to go out? They don't have power to do it. But what they did is karam. Because every one of them, he made tawassul with the good deed that he has done. One of them, he said he has his father and he used to bring the milk to his father all the night and give the father, after that he gave his children. And one night he came and the father was sleeping and he kept waiting for him until Fajr time and give him the milk. He said, oh Allah, if I do that because of you, help me and open for me. And Allah opened for him his part. The other guy, he said that he loves one woman and asked her to sleep with her. He ready to pay her money. The lady son said, no, that is haram. So when the lady get hard time, she come back to the guy and ask him, okay, you give me the money and I sleep with you. So he give her the money. So when he was about to sleep with her, the lady said, fear Allah. And he fear Allah and leave her. And that guy said, oh Allah, if I do that because of you, open for me, and Allah open for him. The other one, somebody was walking with him. The end of the month, he had to pay him, he didn't see him. And he put that money in the farm, and after that, he grow, and he sell that and buy cow for him. After that, he produced a lot of cow. The guy, one day, he passed that area and come to him and said, so I work for you, you have to pay me. You remember that time, you didn't pay me my money? He said, yes. Go behind the house, you see all these cows for you. The guy asked him how, he explained for him. So that guy, he said, he was among the three people. He said, oh Allah, if I do that because of you, open for me. And the rock was upon and they go out. That is one of the karam of the awliya, and you see in Hadith Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So if you, أَلَا إِنَّ أَوْلِيَاءَ اللَّهِ لَا خَفْرٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا مَحْزُونَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَكَانُوا يَتَّقُونَ. If you follow Allah, Allah answer your prayer. But it's not just for flying, but you need to fly. If you need it, maybe you get one point, you have that. But that's nothing for the tasawuf. Because Imam Shazili, he say, if you see somebody flying or somebody walking on water, but he don't follow the Sharia, make sure that it's shaitan. It's not among the Sufi people. So those people, the Sufi, that's not what they're looking for. But if you give yourself to Allah, Allah give you everything. You can do bigger than that. You know Maryam alayhi salam, she's not a prophet, but Allah give her fruit. The time that nobody see fruit, that is karam for her. So whatever, and the ulama, they said, كل ما جاز أن يكون كرامة معجزة للنبي جاز أن يكون كرامة للولي. Anything that possible for a prophet to have like miracle, like معجزة, is possible for a wali to have like karam. You know, Sayyidina Umar in his time, when the Muslim, he was in Sham, in the war, and he was making khutbah, and Allah showed him the army of Muslims, and he calls the guy, he said, Sariya, Jibla, Jibla. He called Sariya. He's in Medina Munawara. Sariya was in Sham, and Sariya heard the voice of Omar. That is one of the karam of the awliya, because Omar is not a prophet. He's wali min awliya, Allah Ta'ala, wa sahabatun ya Rasulillah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So that's
So, but tasawwuf is not for that. Tasawwuf is just to submit yourself to Allah.
Nowadays, there's a lot of knowledge available for the layman, for everybody. And a lot of people think that they have access to the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet. And they don't need a sheikh, for example, or a tariqa to reach the level of their son. What do you say about that?
Everybody need a sheikh to get to that. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said in hadith, that hadith Abu Juhayfa in Tabarani, he said to him, "Sali al-ulama wa khalit al-hukama wa ashabil kubara." He said, ask the ulama, the knowledgeable people, wa ashabil wa khalit al-hukama, and join the wise. If every alim was hakim, he's going to say, Sali al-ulama wa khalitum wa ashabhum. He didn't say, ask them and join them and be with their companion. But he said, Sali al-ulama, that ulama, we need them to teach Quran, to teach Sunnah, to teach what's haram, what is halal, if they only ulama a shariat. But the hukama, they're wise. Those, they are the people who can help you to wash your heart from the bad things. Al-hasad, envy, and all that things, they wash the heart from that. And hadith, inna fil jasadi mudghatan idha salaha salaha al-jasadu kulluhu wa idha fasada fasada al-jasadu kulluhu. Your heart, if it's okay, everything is okay. But he said, washab al-kubara. The kubara, the ulama, they said the kubara, they are the people who knows Allah and can help people to get to that level. That's why we need them. Without those, you can read 100 books, 100,000 books, but you still don't have that maqam, because that maqam you need suluk to be in the way to get it from the people. Good manners is to be nice with everybody. Because they said, even if you be nice with the people and do bad with the cat or anything, that you don't have good manners. Good manners is to forgive people when you have power to defend yourself. They do bad things on you, you forgive them. They don't want to give you, you give them. They don't want to see you, come to visit you, you visit them. That's the good manners that Allah say about Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. قَالَ لَوْ إِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. You have good manners. You know, Imam al-Ghazali was Hujjat al-Islam, one of the biggest scholars in Ummat al-Islamiyah. When he passed away, somebody saw him in dreams and asked him, where Allah take you? Allah take you to paradise? He said, yes. The guy said, I know that that's your place because you wrote a lot of books. You was big, knowledgeable. You do this and do that. He said, not because of all that, those things. He said, one day he was writing, and one fly came to drink from his ink. And he waited for the fly to finish. He said, from that, Allah forgive him and take him to paradise.
My question was, what is the difference between seeing Allah before everything and seeing Allah in everything?
This is the difference between Musa alayhi salam and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. In Quran, Musa, he said, Inna ma'i Rabbi sayhdini. With me, my Lord. So he said with before Lord. But Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he was in the cave with Abu Bakr Siddiq, qala, what he said? La tahzan, inna Allah ma'ana. Don't fear, Allah with us. So Prophet, he mentioned Allah before anything. But Musa, he said, Inna ma'i Rabbi. With me, my Lord. But Prophet said, my Lord with me.
Oh, what about
Tariqa Tijaniya is one of the way of the Sufi. The Sheikh of Tariqa Tijaniya is Sheikh Ahmed Tijani. His grandson of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, descending from Sayyidina Hassan ibn Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu. He was born in Algeria and migrated to Maghreb. And he have many sheikh and he joined many tariqa, but he was worshiping Allah day and night and make salat to al-Nabi all the times until Prophet came to him and give him the tariqa. And the tariqa that Prophet give to him, he said Fatiha 1, and that you know his Quran, and Astaghfirullah 100 times, and La ilaha illallah 100 times, and Salatu ala Nabi 100 times in the morning and the evening. That is the word of Tariqa Tijaniya. They have what they call wazifa, also is part of the word. You do it once a day, also Fatiha and Astaghfirullah al-Azim alladhi la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyul qayyum 30 times, then Salat al-Fatihi, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammadin al-Fatihi lima awlak, al-Khatimi lima sabaka, nasir al-Haqq bil-Haqq, wal-Hadi ila Salatika al-Mustaqim wa ala Ali haqqa qadrihi wa muqdari al-Azim 50 times, then La ilaha illallah 100 times, and another Salat al-Nabi they call Jawharatul Kamal 12 times. Prophet, give it to him and tell him, anybody have this tariqa and use it, you have good ending and you will know Allah and you will go to paradise with your children and your wife.
Bismillah. Against this part as innovators and so on. Those people who make wrong allegation against the people who follow this part, what do you say about that?
Those people who criticize this way, what do you say?
What I said to them, what my grandfather, Sheikh Ibrahim radiallahu anhu, he told one scholar in Saudi Arabia, he was criticized the tariqa, and he asked him, what is the tariqa? The guy don't know the answer. And Sheikh Ibrahim told him, there is two tariqa. If you like to choose any one of those, choose one of those. Zikrullahi wa mahabbatu awliya'illahi wa tarku zikrillahi wa mu'adat awliya'illahi. Mention Allah and love the awliya of Allah. He said that is the first one, we choose that. And he told the guy, if you like to choose the other one, to don't mention Allah and against awliya illah, choose that, you have right for that. But each one of those, you have the result. Because mahabbatu mu'adatu awliya illahi, to against the awliya of Allah, Allah say in Hadith al-Qudsi, من عادى لي وليا فقد آذنته بالحرب. Whoever against my wali, I fight with him. So if Allah fight with anybody, you're gonna be a loser. And Sheikh Ahmed Tijani said, what you can understand from that hadith, if Allah say, who against my wali, I fight with him, that also you understand, who loves my wali, because he's my wali, I will choose him as a wali. Mention Allah also. Allah say, "Wazkuruni azkurkum." You mention me, I mention you. And if you don't want to mention Allah, woman arada an zikri fa inna lahu ma'ishatan dankan. People who don't mention Allah, they have hard life in the last day. And he asked him, our tariqa is this, what I just mentioned. Fatiha. You know Fatiha is part of Quran. And it's not only part of Quran, but the Fatiha is the best surah of Quran. Allah say in Quran, فَقْرَأُوا مَا تَيَسَّرَ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ. Read whatever you can read from Quran. So if you're reading this word,
You come to read Fatiha, you remember that Allah said, فَقْرَوْ مَا تَيَسَّرَ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ. That's why you're reading it. Then you make Astaghfirullah 100 times. And Prophet himself is ma'asum. He couldn't make any sins. It's not possible for him to do it. But with all that, he keeps saying Astaghfirullah. He said, إِنِّي لَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ بَيْنَ الْيَوْمِ وَاللَّيْلَ مِئَةَ مَرَةٍ. He said, I ask Allah for forgiveness between day and night 100 times. In another hadith, he said, Sab'ina Mara, 70 times. So he asked him, is possible for me and you to leave istighfar? The guy said, no. That how you advise your brother Muslim to stop saying istighfar is possible? The guy said, no. He asked him, after that, we made Salatu ala Nabi. Any Salatu ala Nabi? That Allah says in the Quran, إِنَّ اللَّهُ مَلَائِكَةُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. Allah and His angel, they send blessing to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who you believe, sending salutation to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He asked him, if it's possible to advise your brother Muslim to stop saying that? The guy said, no. And you know in hadith, مَنْ صَلَّى عَلَيْهِ صَلَاةً وَاحِدَةً صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ بِهَا عَشْرًا. If you send one salat to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah sent 10 to you, and that is better than all your life. One salat from Allah to you is better than all your life. And whenever you make salat to al-Nabi, Allah sent 10 to you. After that, we say, La ilaha illallah. Prophet said, أَفْضَلُ مَا قُلْتُهُ أَنَا وَالنَّبِيُّونَ مِنْ قَبْلِي لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. The best thing that I ever said, and all the old anbiya they ever said, is La ilaha illallah. This word, if somebody was in Kufr 100 years and Allah bless him with this word, you said it and believe it, one moment, all these 100 years change. How come you advise your brother Muslim to stop saying that? Is it possible? The guy said, no, it's not possible. And remaining after that, we're doing it in the morning and in the evening.
You read the Quran with some people who got the wasiyah. Mention Allah in the morning and in the evening. That's our answer for them. Also, we don't need to fight each other. If anybody wanna stay doing only his farida, bismillah, that's okay. But if you wanna have more, you do more. Like your job, you wanna get more money, you do more job.
لا يزال عبدي يتقرب إلي بنوافل الخير حتى أحبه. In Hadith al-Qudsi, Allah said, my servant will stay doing the nafila of good things until we get to the point that I love him. And if I love him, I come to be his hand, his eyes, his ears, his everything. So that's why what he was asking, if Allah come to be your arm, you can do everything with your arm. If Allah come to be your eyes, you can do everything with your eyes. Your everything. So no way to get to that point without the nafila to zikri. And the tariqah is nothing but nawafil al-khair. You said, somebody asked Ihsan, what Prophet said, you worship Allah as you are seeing Him. If you want to get explanation for that, go back to yourself and your situation with your boss. If you're walking, if you're walking and your boss watching you, what are you going to do? You do it in the best way. That day is going to be your best day in your walks. You're walking, you're facing your boss, he's seeing you, you're seeing him, you do it the best way. Even if you don't see him, but you know he watching you or somebody there, he's going to give report to your boss, you do it in the best way. So if you do it with Allah by the maqam of Ihsan, that's the way you're going to do everything. You do it because you know you do it in front of Allah. You do it the best way. So if you, the people you respect, your parents, you respect them. Anything they ask you to do in front of them, you do it the best way. Your boss, so what do you think if you get to that maqam with Allah?
Alaykum salam.
To worship me, but Ibn Abbas, he said the meaning is worship me to know me. You know him before you worship him. Even the small things, you know, no way you can make salat without know what salat. You have to know Fatiha, you know, have to know Surah of Quran. That's the first level. So there's the level bigger than higher than that. How you know Allah? You go with people, you have the sheikhs who knows Allah, and they give you, you go with them, you're going to get to the end. Where they end, you get to that.
We will have just one last question, and then we will be closing this, please. One last question. Is that a question?
Yes, that question. Allah, I say, is only reality. But nothing else you can't say is Allah. Allah is Allah, nothing else. And I say it's only reality because reality is never changing. Allah, who will haq, is reality. So it's never changed. Anything else you see change. So, but to get to that point is not something that they just tell you, you have it like that. You have to go to the way and, you know, worship Allah and mention Allah day and night until Allah put the light in your heart and you know that that reality. But Allah say, Laysa kimislihi shay, nothing like him. And the Sufi, they say, Kullu ma khatara bi balika fallahu bi khilafi dhalik. Anything that you think about, Allah differ from that.
قد استأصل المحبوب كلي وجملتي وواصلني وغيري تتاولتي قد استأصل المحبوب كلي وجملتي وواصلني وغيري تتاولتي وها إن للعبد غيب إلهنا وقلب والذات في تجلتي فصلت عليه فهو بطل وظاهر وظاهر عبد وللبطن صلت أفضله منهم إليه فهالي وحيا رسول الله والعين كالتي فتيمني شوقا وعز لقاء إليس لا تجدي والأقدام ضلت أهيم بطرا ألذ بكري فاسر وطرا لم أر ويرى وصلتي وطرا أرى أن الحياة مريدة وطرا أرى بنيتي ما بنيت ذات كار أطواري بشوق حبيبنا تكل قيامي ويا عين ما ضلتي صلاة على عين عيوبها غيبها وآل وصحب ما العيون اضمحلتي قد استأصل المحبوب